Bridges are one of the most important types of infrastructure. They connect neighborhoods like Manhattan and Brooklyn, cities like San Francisco and Oakland, and even countries like the United States and Canada. It's one of the only ways of providing a way over an obstacle. Another way is through tunnels. But like any structure, bridges are vulnerable to earthquakes. If a bridge isn't designed to withstand earthquakes, it can collapse. Not only could this cause injuries if someone was on or under the bridge when it collapsed, but it will also cause major traffic disruptions. It will cause traffic jams on the tours, and even could leave a place without a land connection at all, if it's an island, for example. So earthquake resistance is very important. But how is it done? In this video, I'll explain how bridges are made earthquake-proof. Base isolation is the most common way of protecting bridges from earthquakes. As the name suggests, the idea behind this is to isolate the superstructure, which in this case is a bridge, from the base. Base isolators consist of three main parts: the bearing, which absorbs the energy of an earthquake, and two steel plates, one of which connects the bearing to the base, and the other connects the bearing to the superstructure. When the ground shakes, the base, or the substructure, which is firmly attached to the ground, also begins to shake, causing the bearing to move and stretch. As it does so, it absorbs most of the energy of the earthquake, leaving the superstructure almost motionless. When the shaking stops, the bearing returns to its original position, and so the superstructure remains intact. The most common type of bearing is the lead rubber bearing, which consists of a lead core in the middle and layers of rubber and steel around it. This is the most common type of bearing and is used in bridges all over the world, including New Zealand, Japan and the United States, as well as many other countries. The iconic 6th Street Viaduct in Los Angeles was also equipped with lead rubber bearings when it was rebuilt. In some cases, engineers use springs instead of lead rubber bearings, but they work on the same principles. Base isolation is not the only way of protecting bridges from earthquakes. Tuned mass dampers, which are common in skyscrapers, can also be used in bridges for seismic proofing. Tuned mass dampers consist of a mass, springs and dampers. When the bridge starts to shake, say to the left, the mass of the tuned mass damper moves in the opposite direction, to the right. This, with the help of the dampers, quickly stops the bridge from moving. It kind of cancels the movement. Dampers are really important, or rather the substance inside them, called magnetorological fluid. MR fluid is a liquid that turns into near solid under the influence of magnetic force, and turns back into a liquid when the magnetic force is removed. During an earthquake, this fluid inside the dampers will change from solid to liquid back and forth, as the shaking activates the magnetic force inside the damper. When done correctly, tuned mass dampers can protect bridges from vibrations caused by wind, earthquakes, and even pedestrians on footbridges. They are really effective. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye.